What's up, gang? It's your boy Ajax, and today I'm breaking down the top 20 cents of the early 2000s. Let's get nasty.
Give it to me, big boy. Yeah.
20.
The Suzuki Q Chord. She likes the bowling ball grip. Two in the pink, one in the stink.
A Suzuki Q Chord has two voices with waveforms, onboard effects that include reverb and vibrato. You can play chords easily and strum along with that touch-sensitive strip. And if you hook this thing up to guitar pedals or multi-effects processor, then you're playing with pure magic.
19.
Red Sound Elevator. There's a lot of preparation, but no H.
It's a 16-voice polyphonic synth with two oscillators, standard LFO, with effects that include chorus and flanger, and a simple mod matrix. The best part of the Elevator is the layout and its usability. The sound is a bit sterile and cold, but it sounds great for effects, phase strings, or hollow pads, 80s bass lines, and those metallic leads.
18.
Emu XL7. She's a donk.
It has 128 voices with tasty drum kits. It's the perfect groove machine for sending MIDI info to other synths. The velocity ribbon is fun and the pads are spongy just so you can beat that thing. The stock patterns are a bit weak, but the real meat lies in the onboard arpeggiator with over 200 patterns to get you grooving. The internal synth is fully capable and excels at trap, hip-hop, electro, and jungle.
17.
Waldorf Micro-Q.
Hey mom, cookies are done!
A polyphonic synth with 25 voices, 3 LFOs, a multi-mode filter, 5 effects, and an insane mod matrix. The multi-mode filter can be routed in serial parallel, but the mod matrix coming up with those Stranger Things sounds is a cinch. You can also use auxiliary input for creating those Daft Punk sweeps.
16.
Future Retro XS. Let's go back to the future with Analog.
It's a mono synth with two oscillators, standard LFOs, and one chunky filter. It sounds thicker than the 303 and squelches more than the Moog Fatty. It's built like a tank, the layout is groovy, and the sound is raw. The bass is punchy and the mid-range has a nice crunch. So if you can get one for a bargain, pay the man.
15.
Yamaha DX200. She's tight, tiny, and packs a punch.
Finally, FM programming at your fingertips. It has 16 voices with a sub-synth multi-mold digital filter and 21 LFOs with 13 effects. Yep, that's why they hold her value. She's totally bitchin'. The icing on the cake is a 16-step sequencer with real-time motion control. With those 16 knobs and wicked onboard effects, the DX200 will have you calling into work in no time.
14.
Radical Technology Spectralis. Whoop, there it is!
It has 32 voices with 4 oscillators, a multi-mold filter, delay effects, 24-track sequencer, 10 LFOs, and an onboard sampler. The filter is made up of a filter bank which has 8 bandpasses, 1 low pass, and 1 high pass. The sampler isn't an MPC, but it's still sophisticated and sounds excellent. With the mod matrix, LFOs, and the filter, you can create unusual and creative tones.
13.
Electron SFX-6. Like a taser gun straight to the peepee.
Has 6 voices, a whopping 18 LFOs, and a quality effects section that include delay, EQ, sample rate, and distortion. With the Superwave oscillators, the SFX can sound thick and juicy. The onboard SID chip emulation will send you straight into mushroom land, and the ensemble wave creates those lush pads and rhythms. The SFX-6 also employs FM synthesis, so you can create those staccato tones, razor leads, and nasty effects.
12.
Oberheim OB-12, the return of the Mac.
Not bad for an Italian synth with the Oberheim name slapped on it. It's a 12-voice poly synth with standard LFOs, a multi-mold filter, and effects that include overdrive, chorus, delay, and reverb. With all those buttons, sliders, knobs, and a velocity ribbon, you can create some original sounds.
11.
Roland V-Synth, the monster in your closet. And I'm not talking about your mother-in-law.
Has 24 voices with 2 oscillators that have 14 analog waves and 300 PCM waveforms, and a built-in sampler which you can use to create your own PCM waveforms. It has a massive pro effects section with too many effects to list. My favorite part of the V-Synth is the pattern editor, which you can use to create complex arpeggiators quickly, easily with the LCD.
10.
Korg MS-2000D. Ah, the stairway to heaven.
It's a 4-voice polysynth with 2 digital oscillators and 64 digital waveforms, a variable delay, chorus flange and EQ, and a brilliant vocoder. It's not very warm, but sounds smooth, vibrant, and lush. The best part of the synth is the 16-part sequencer, which you can use as an ARP to create complex and inspiring rhythms.
9.
Moog Mini Voyager. She'll rock your world.
The original monophonic bass synth with that classic big bottom. The layout is excellent and the Moog filter is so thick and juicy. And if you route that audio back to the input, she'll get down like Julie Brown. If it's good enough for Daft Punk and Deadmau5, it's good enough for any artist.
Analog Solutions Red Square.
Hey Red, you wanna grab a colada?
It's a monophonic synth with two oscillators with the sub and that big old juicy Moog filter. The Red Square's oscillators and filter are guaranteed to keep you warm on a cold winter night. If you want a patchable Moog that stands out from the rest, then this is the one.
7.
Macbeth M5. If she was a woman, she'd be a tall, blue-eyed, blonde German with a 12-inch strap-on.
Oh. Mommy?
The M5 has three analog oscillators, standard LFO, and a fat analog filter. The layout and the size make it easier to work with, and the girth is well worth every penny. There's no MIDI, but you got CV. With the M5, we be big pimpin'.
6.
The Access Virus TI. That dirty dominatrix that just needs a whoopin'.
The Virus TI is an 80-voice polyphonic monster with three oscillators, one sub, and a four-stage filter with a massive list of pro effects. It always shines over VSTs, and having those knobs with Total Recall make it all worthwhile. The arpeggiator is quick and easy to use, so you can come up with advanced patterns and rhythms.
5.
Studio Electronics Omega 8. He's a full-figured gal.
It's an 8-voice polyphonic monster with two analog oscillators and a sub-oscillator, sporting three multi-function LFOs and that fat filter. Ooh yeah! The best part of the Omega is the multi-mode filter, which creates serious thumpage. The Omega can be squelchy, smooth, or in between. It's a true beauty and sounds as good as she looks.
4.
Jomag Sunsin, great balls of fire!
True analog beast with 8 voices, 2 oscillators, a standard LFO section, and a massive mod matrix. King Kong ain't got shit on this. Its tone is thick and perfect for those fat and meaty bass lines. And with the advanced mod matrix, things can get complicated quickly. And that's a good thing. The filter cuts through like butter, and the knobs will have your thumb sore in no time. With those two beefy analog oscillators and those digital waveforms under the hood, it's a true collector's dream.
3.
Dave Smith, Polyvolver. The Blue Dream sounds so clean, it'll make you cream.
Yeah.
It's a 4-voice polyhybrid synth that has 2 analog oscillators and 2 digital oscillators and 16 LFOs. Polyvolver has a Mac Daddy filter that resonates enough to annoy your neighbors and dogs for miles. If the beast isn't sexy enough, the analog delay will blow your panties right off, and the distortion will send you straight to Nirvana.
2.
Clavia Nord Lead 3. It's like hopping on the back of a Minotaur high on crack. Ha ha!
Nord Lead 3 is a 24-voice polyphonic beast. It has a one-of-a-kind filter which makes it one of the gnarliest synths on the planet. With a mod wheel, pitch bender, and all those knobs, what's not to love? The Nord 3 is a heavy hitter, and she's got that special sauce. Don't be fooled by the other Nords, because the Nord 3 is the jam.
1.
Delicious Andromeda. Woo! Let's take Valka for a ride around the galaxy.
Delicious Andromeda is a polyphonic behemoth with 16 voices, 2 oscillators with subs. It has a multi-mode filter that begs to be tweaked. The onboard effects include reverb, echo, chorus, analog distortion, pitch shifting, and flange. It's got a standard arpeggiator and a 16-step sequencer. What sets this board apart from all the others is its brilliant layout with knobs and buttons galore and that velocity-sensitive ribbon that turns it into a true Hendrix machine. If you're in the market, be sure to sanitize her down to the ground, because good old Scotty Kirkland has juiced all over this gal.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe, because I got to get a couple cents out of the pawn shop. You know what I'm saying. Hit the bell if you want to feel a tingle in the jingle. Peace!